So welcome to Yin Yoga. And Yin Yoga is different from going to a vinyasa class or hatha class when you work more with muscles. In this class, we work with a deep connective tissue that is located in between the muscles. And we also work with fascia, which is this thin film of stretchy tissue that is going through the body. And one of the things fascia does is to hold together other tissue. So we can do a little test here, so it makes more clear what we're gonna do. So if you hold your hand and really flex your fingers and gently try to pull one finger out, not much happens. But if you relax your hand and then try and pull, then you can see there is more giveaway there. So that's what we're doing today. And we are concentrating on hips and spine. Together, we're working with the shoulder openers and wrists and hands. So hope you will enjoy this practice. Just setting there here. Okay. So starting in a comfortable cross-leg position, if you need to sit on a bolster or a blanket, you can do that to get a more forward tilt with your hips. Hands in a comfortable position, maybe on your knees or on your lap. Let's start with two cleansing breaths. Inhale through your nose and exhale, mouth. One more time. Inhale and exhale. Just normal breath in and out through your nose. Not trying to control your breath here. Start scanning your body. Starting from your feet, moving up your ankles, your shin bones, your calves, your knees. Do you feel tense today, relaxed, energized, calm? Moving up your thighs, your hamstrings, hips. Connecting with your belly, your rib cage, your chest, your heart. Feeling your fingers, your hands, your wrists, your arms, or your shoulders relaxed. See how your neck is doing. Make sure you relax your jaw. Feel the face, the crown of your head. And just sit in stillness. If you have a lot of thoughts going on, start following your breath. And every time a new thought comes up, just acknowledge it and get back to your breath. Start a pranayama breathing exercise. It's a three-part breath. So starting with the belly and then inhaling to your rib cage. You're going to hold a few seconds and then move up to your chest area and then hold there. So hold three different areas and then slowly exhale all the way down. So pay attention to your belly, inhale there, hold. Move your breath up to your rib cage, hold. And move the breath all the way to your chest area, hold. And slowly let the breath out all the way down to your belly again. Let's do this a few times. So inhale, belly, hold. Chest, hold. Ribcage and then chest hold. And let go. Again, belly. Ribcage. And chest. Let go. And do it a few more times. In your own pace. And when you're done, just normal breath in and out through your nose again. See how you feel. See where your thoughts are. And slowly open your eyes. Just roll your shoulders forward and back. And opposite. The whole time, smooth, steady breath. And let go. Starting with child pose today. As always, we have options. So if you can, knees together and buttocks on your knees. And then you can place your arms behind you. Forehead on the floor. If this is not comfortable, or if your buttocks don't come down to your heels, you can take a blanket and see if that feels better, and then come down. Other option is to have, if you have small towels or so under your ankles, it hurts under your ankles, you can have your arms forward. Or if the knees together don't work, have wider knees. Then even use a pillow or a blanket, put your head on. So try it out a little. And I'm gonna start the counting before we get started. So before we settle in here. Okay, hopefully you found something that works for you today. And then relax into the pose. You probably feel your breath really well all the way down to your belly, since this is a forward bend. The exhale also is probably longer than the inhales, which is very soothing for the nervous system. So you will feel calmer. And as always, if something doesn't feel comfortable or if you have any pain, just back out and switch the pose out a little bit.
nice stretch for your spine. You may feel it in your hips.
Let's do 5 last breaths in this pose. And then slowly walk your hands back and come up to seated. Let's take a few breaths here. Come to cat-cow, do a few of those, just moving your spine. So spread your fingers, hands under your shoulders, and knees under your hips. Inhale, cat, and exhale, belly to floor, look up. Exhale, tuck your chin. And come up again. Move with your breath. Let's do one more. And then come to neutral spine. Next one is melting heart. So you may want to move a little further back on your mat. Knees hip width apart. You want to have your hips over the knees the whole time. So I show the first option is just walking your hands as far as you can. And then chest to floor, forehead to floor. So you should feel a stretch here in your shoulder area, pressing both hands to the floor. This may not be comfortable for all of you, or you may have a tingling sensation in your fingers. If you do, move your hands back, maybe even forehead on the floor and forearms a little bit. If your knees hurt, you can take a blanket and put under your knees. You can even use a bolster here. Maybe come here. So you need to play around a little bit again. And if you're really, really flexible, you can have your chin forward and look forward. That's too much for me. So take a few more seconds here to settle in. So again, hips and knees align. And then move your hands forward and settle in to the pose. So check in, see if it's comfortable for you. Otherwise, maybe move your hands. See how your neck is feeling. You don't want to feel too much tension there. A smooth, steady breath. And as I said in the beginning of the class, if you have a lot of thoughts going on, just start following your breath. It's very soothing. Doesn't matter how many times you have to come back to your breath. We'll stay here for one more minute. And slowly come all the way down. Palms on top of each other, if that's comfortable. Forehead on top. You want to move your hips from side to side. And then place your arms alongside you. Palms facing up if it's comfortable. And head to one side here. Relax. And move your head to the other side. Stay here for a little while too. Thought I had set my screen so it doesn't turn off. But it's turning off, so no luck. Never. Okay, now I set it. And slowly come all the way up. And come over. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. Inhale and exhale. Hands on your thighs. Relax your shoulders here. Breathe all the way down to your belly. All the way up through the crown of your head. And all the way down again. Continue like this. Feel the earth beneath you. Feel how it supports you and grounds you. And next one, Sphinx pose. Coming down to your belly again. Okay, continue. So, options. You can start with taking your hands to the opposite elbow, feet about hip width apart. Option forming almost like a triangle with your hands. So palms are on the floor, facing down, or hands are parallel with the shoulders here, pressing your elbows back. So you're opening your heart, have a broad collarbone here. If this is not comfortable for you, or if it's too much for your back, you can move your elbows forward to come down a little more. You can even take a blanket and place, let's see here, under your armpit and see if this works better. So different options again. See what works. Get settled in. A few seconds here. So let's come into stillness again. Make sure your jaw is relaxed. Concentrate on the space in between your thoughts. So if this feels a lot in your shoulder area, try and relax as much as you can, even if you feel it's a little bit uncomfortable here. Just like in life, trying to be as relaxed and at ease when we have difficult situations makes it easier. Using your breath the whole time. Remember, you can always adjust the pose. And notice if your breath is longer compared to when we started the class. Maybe you feel more relaxed. Staying here for about 30 more seconds. And slowly come all the way down. Turn your head to the right side. Cactus arms. And take the left knee up. So it's aligned with the left, not the left leg, the right knee aligned with the right hip here. Let's see if you can relax. I can definitely feel this in my shoulders. So it's nice to relax in between each pose. And if something else that feels more comfortable for you, you can of course change around, or just sometimes a small adjustment goes a long way. Let's switch side. So head goes to the left, bending the left knee and relax. Slowly coming up, take your hands to the floor and press up. Ah. Coming to half shoelace. So I think I'm gonna sit on a blanket today. Bending your right knee first. Left leg over. So if you go to full pose, you're stacking your hips. I know this is not available for everyone. And once you're here, you can play a little bit with the feet out and in. You feel this different areas of your hips. Other option, straighten your right leg. Flex your left foot. Make sure it's not directly on the knee. So over the knee works here. So you may want to sit on a blanket again. So this is just half the pose. We're going to add arms to this. And of course, if you don't want to do it, if you just want to do the legs, do that. If you want to do your arms, come to cow face arms. So you may want to have a strap, or if you have a belt. Take your right arm back. So you're opening the shoulder here again. Take a few breaths here. Left arm out and see if you can connect your hands together. If that doesn't happen, you can use, I'll do it from the side maybe, or show you from the back. You can just stay here. And if you don't have a blanket, a strap or so, you can just stay here too. So let's get ready. So option again, if you just want to do your legs, do that, or use a strap. Since we're going to sit in this pose for a long time, I am going to use a strap. So let's see if we can sit here maybe for 3 minutes. And just try and relax again, all your muscles. Feel the stretch in your shoulder area.
And close your eyes, make it comfortable for you. And after a while, if you want to go deeper into your hips, you can just fold forward a little bit more. Just an option. Invite stillness. And draw your attention to any tense areas you have. And just imagine, relax, relax more in these areas. About 1 more minute here. And slowly come up. Oh, legs out too. Shake it out if that feels good. Move your shoulders back and forth. And then press your palms together here. Feels good, at least for me. I hope it does for you. Otherwise, do something different. Shake it out. And one more side. Sometimes I'm glad I just have 2 arms. So, this time, bending your left knee first. Right knee over. So both sitting bones on the floor. If they're not on the floor, sit on a blanket. Or option to straighten the left leg here. Once you figure out how your legs are gonna do, we're gonna work on the arms. Let's just open up before we come into the pose in stillness. So take your left arm, gently press back, opening up your shoulder. Arm out, and see how this side feels. Again, use a belt or so if you need to. And I will start to count. You may notice this side is much more open for you, or maybe it's the reverse.
You should have one sinus that's easier. Work on letting go again, relaxing and breathing. Maybe after a minute or two, your hands can come closer. Maybe you want to lean forward to work more in your hips. Let's see if you can keep that smooth, steady breath all the way through your belly and up. Not forcing it. And stay here for about 10 more breaths. And slowly come up and let go of the belt if you're holding one, or strap. And roll your shoulders back and forth. Maybe shake it out. Take your arms out. Right arm under the left. Eagle arms. Open up your shoulders. This feels good. Just as a counter pose. Staying here. Maybe 10 breaths. Let go. Shake it out. Deep inhale, arms up and down. Same thing, other side. Arms out, and this time left arm under, pressing your palms together and elbows together. And stay here for a few breaths again. Thank you.
let go.
Let's come to your back. Like we need to lay down a little and hug your knees in. Just melt down into the floor here. Let your shoulders relax. We did a lot of shoulder work now. You can be in stillness here if you prefer to move your knees to side, you can do that. Let's stay here and ground down here. Make sure your neck is relaxed, your jaw is relaxed, your face is relaxed. Hands under your knees, roll on your spine a few times. Give yourself some massage. Come all the way up. Butterfly next. As always, you can sit on a blanket so you have a more forward tilt. Because you want that nice long spine here. Especially the sacrum. Feet together. Elbows on the inside of the knees. And then come down here. We're gonna work your wrists here. So if that's too much, you can even put some books or blocks under your knees. You can use a pillow or a bolster maybe in the front here. I'm gonna come forward with your back. And if you have a back problem, you can stay up here too. Then we're gonna turn your palms facing the ceiling. Place them in front of your feet. And see if the whole hand, all the way up to the wrist, can be on the floor. So you're opening up here. So you should feel this in your forearms. You can play with your hands maybe further forward. You should feel your hips more, depends on how flexible you are, or come up a little more. And then settle in here. So pressing down with your hands, feel this in your forearms. If it's too much, just come up and work on the butterfly. Stillness. Maybe after a minute or so, you can come down even further. We'll lean forward more. I can feel. Notice that my mind starts wandering more if something's uncomfortable. So I just make a note of it and then try to gently get back to my breathing. I'm trying to relax as much as I can. stay for a few more breaths. And palms to the floor and come up. Shake it out again. Hands behind you. Windshield. You feel good after this. Coming into butterfly one more time, but with a different hand position. Okay, let's set up butterfly. So this time, palms face down. Spread your fingers, the whole hands, all the way up to the wrists are on the floor. Press down and then press in. So this time you still feel in the forearms, but maybe more on the back side, or I don't know if you would call this the back side, maybe this is the back side, on the inside of the forearm. And once you've found your position, maybe close your eyes, come into stillness again. And I will start counting. What you learn here in yoga, you can take with you out in life outside the yoga practice. A lot of people are not aware of their thought patterns. For example, you have this talk to yourself all the time, and the same things come up time after time. Some of it may not be positive. So during yoga class, you may notice some of that. And the more you notice it, the easier, hopefully, it will be to go back off out of that thought pattern, even outside the yoga class. Just be kind and gentle to yourself with your thoughts. Have about 30 more seconds here in this pose. And slowly come up. Oh, that was a lot of shoulder work. And hands, wrists. Coming down on your back. Feet a little wider than your hips. You can have your arms in cactus position. And then just use your legs as wind wipers. Release any tension from your lower back, your spine, your hips. A Your shoulders are resting on the floor, totally relaxed. Palms are relaxed. Next time, your knees are out to the side, the right side. Stay here. Let gravity do its work. So hopefully this feels really relaxing for you. Even turn your head to the left side here. A little stretch in the right side of your neck. And look up again towards the ceiling and move your knees over to the left side and stay here. And again, you can move your hands if you have a tingling sensation of your fingers. You may want to move your elbows down to see what works for you. And as we did on the other side, you may want to turn your head this time to the right side. And soles of the feet to the floor again. Look up. Let's do some extended bridge pose. So arms are long, palms facing down. Inhale, arms overhead. Hips up. And hands on the floor behind you. Exhale, slowly come down. One more time. Inhale, hips up and arms over. And let's do one third time. Inhale up and over. And exhale down. Take some breaths here and relax. Coming into banana pose. So extend your legs and move your hips a little over to the right. And then move your feet over to the left. So you want both hips pressed down to the floor. So you don't want to come up here, both hips pressed down. Arms overhead and move your hands and your shoulders over to the left side. Just like a banana. If you feel that your right shoulders have a tendency to come up, you can even take a blanket and maybe place under, not too high though. Just could help a little bit here. So settle into the pose. So again, pressing both hips down, same time. Elongating the right side, your waist, your rib cage. Thank you.
can stay where you are, or maybe see if you can make that arch a little bigger, moving your arms a little bit more out to the left side and the feet a little bit more out too. Just stay there. Staying here for 2 more minutes, about. Every time we do yoga, it feels a little bit different usually. One day we have a lot of energy, we are open, we feel flexible, we have balance. The next time we may not feel to even doing it. Just honor how you feel today. If it's good, you're tired, whatever it is. At least you showed up to yoga. That's worth a lot. Okay, about 10 more breaths here. Slowly come to the middle again. And feet off the floor. Maybe wide knees here. Moving from side to side. And then stillness, press your knees down. Or if you prefer to do something else. Maybe circle your ankles. And stretch out. Ready for banana on the other side. So move the feet over opposite side and both hips to the floor. Move your shoulders out, your arms out. Settled in into the pose. And come to stillness. And do what you did on the other side, maybe moving a little bit more deeper into the pose, or stay where you are.
Checking with your breath.
Smooth, steady. Checking with your mind. Start deepening your breath, a few breaths, and then we're going to come out of the pose. Come to the middle. Feet on the floor again to start with. And then feet off the floor. Hug your knees in, moving from side to side. We'll draw circles with your knees. Come to stillness again and see, maybe shoulders off the floor, forehead up. Just stay for a few breaths. And slowly come down, stretching your legs out, arms overhead. Get real, real long. And we are ready for Shavasana. So if you want to use a bolster or a pillow under your knees, you want to do that, that's very, very relaxing. Or if you want to come to the regular Savasana. Feet a little wider than your hips, let your feet hang out to the sides. Arms about 45 degrees from your body, palms facing up, chin slightly tucked. If you have an eye pillow, could be really relaxing. Placing that over your eyes. If you have a blanket, you can cover yourself in the blanket. So get settled into corpse pose. Take two cleansing breaths here and then just melt into the floor. So inhale through your nose and exhale through the mouth. One more time, inhale. And exhale, and just melt into the floor. Bring your awareness to the crown of your head. Inhale. And exhale, relax the forehead, soften your eyes, your jaw. Inhale to the sides of the neck. And exhale, relax the muscles around your neck. Inhale. And exhale, relax your spine. Just feel the weight and the muscles around your spine. Inhale and exhale. Feel the shoulders relaxed into the floor. Inhale into your chest. And relax the chest.
Inhale your arms, your hands. And exhale. Relax and lift. Bring your awareness to your lower back and your sacrum. Inhale and relax and exhale here. Inhale deeply into your feet and your legs. And relax your legs, your feet. Just normal breathing in and out through your nose. Smooth, steady breath. Slowly start deepening and lengthening your breath and bring your awareness back to your physical body. Slowly start moving your toes, your fingers. Soles of the feet to the floor, arms extend over your head. And press yourself to the right side, resting on the upper right arm. Take a few breaths there. And when you're ready, with your eyes still closed, come up to a comfortable seated cross-leg position. Take a moment and scan your body again. Hopefully you feel more calm and relaxed than you did when we started the class. Maybe your breath is a little smoother and deeper. Maybe there's more space in between each thought. Just thank yourself and honor whatever you feel today and know that it's okay. Palms together in front of your heart center. Don't compare your life to others. There is no comparison between the sun and the moon. They both shine bright when it's their time. Thank you for being here and practicing with me today. Let's bow your head to seal the practice, fingers to the third eye in between your eyebrows. Have a beautiful day, everyone. Namaste. Thank you all for being here.